Transparent armor is bulletproof glass in the simplest terms. Spinel is an evolutionary improvement in transparent armor. What we have been able to do is to reduce the thickness of that armor by a factor of two by simply redesigning the architecture. Using the same materials, the same weight, we're able to reduce the thickness by a factor, which has a huge impact on the weight.
Spinel is a magnesium aluminum oxide. It's an actual crystalline material that ends up looking transparent, like a piece of glass.
No one else domestically can make spinel powder better than us. That's our beauty, and we are very confident, and we have actually transitioned our technologies to other companies. So they know we can make good powder, and we can make good devices.
What we do is turn the powder into a solid, transparent shape that looks like glass. What we use for that is this 50-ton hot press. The hot press, what it does is it acts like a furnace. It'll go to 3,600 degrees Fahrenheit, and through this hydraulic system, it'll exert a 50-pound load on the sample.
So what we're talking about here is to replace glass with spinel. Because it's significantly tougher, stronger, harder than the glass, it's a lot thinner and reduces the weight considerably. And the idea was, typically, the bullet goes straight through. There's a shockwave created, and it literally pulverizes the material ahead of the bullet, and it's like a bullet just traveling through sand. It just goes through very easily. There's very little resistance. What we'd like to do is to increase that resistance, and we'd like to use more of the material to dissipate that energy. So because we have a background in optics, and we understand that if I take a laser pointer and I have a stack of glass slides and I illuminate, well, you'll see reflection of light at every interface. So our thought was, well, can't we leverage that same concept in a shockwave? Can't we dissipate shockwave energy? So we redesigned the structure, and in fact, went ahead and shot at the material and demonstrated through high-speed videography, we were able to exploit more of the material to absorb that energy by dissipating the shockwave. We're also looking at polymers and plastics. Certainly in the case of transparent armor, big thrust is to reduce the weight, to provide protection against even higher caliber round. And so what we had observed was that we could take existing plastics, existing polymers, and through by just simply redesigning the architecture, so not selecting different materials as are commercially available, but take existing commercial polymer armor, but redesign the architecture, we could provide enhanced protection to the warfighter. By that I mean we reduce the thickness and therefore the weight. What we'd like to do is to marry that technology with Spinel as the strike plate to replace the glass at the front end with our, we call it biomimetic armor, the polymer, to combine the two together to provide protection against a higher caliber round, such as a NATO 7.62 round, and to be able to do this by reducing the weight by a factor of two or more. In the next 5 to 10 years, the goal is really to really understand the shockwave dissipation mechanism so we can optimize the transparent armor through clever design. The marrying of Spinel ceramic and polymer and the design, the architecture of these, so we can significantly reduce the weight going forward.